That night he drove to the graveyard and dug up her lifeless body. He then eagerly returned home, positioned the corpse in his bed, and after almost 40 years of celibacy, thusly began his first intimate acquaintance with the female gender.
Describe for me what the terrorist implications for such a weapon would be.
They're so hideous that I think the use of just one of these devices at an appropriate place will have such horrendous effects on the world, you know, psychologically, the world would never be the same.
Thank you. Joy is a fucking pain! 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 Joy is a fucking pain!
Zero fucking tolerance.
Yeah. and they sit around and don't know what the fuck is going on.
Fucking hate myself.
They're stupid. Fuck, they're ignorant.
Thank you.
I wanted to die. I tried to die, but I didn't. They say it's my depression, but what the fuck, man? I don't fucking know anymore. Which way should I fucking turn, man?
mutilation of the body, the dismemberment of the body, the discarding of body parts, the destroying pieces of the body.
I have tapes of victims who are being murdered, who are regressing in their behavior, calling out for their mommies, calling out for their daddies, and begging and please God, please don't kill me. But they kill them. Pathologists should be able to determine the cause of death, the manner and mechanism of death, the length of time it took the individual to die, the nature of the assault.
But the most horrifying deaths come at the hands of serial murderers, people who actually enjoy making other people suffer and die.
And the killing part in my mind became as exciting as the molesting was.
Lampshades out of skin. He had body parts all around his house.
He wrote of a wounded child pleading, "I'm sorry, I'm sorry," before Dodd stabbed him again. Another entry says, "I think I got more of a high out of killing than molesting." His record lists him as rebellious, incorrigible, with signs of sadism and pedophilia. Shut up!
I am what a child molester looks like. There is no dirty old man. Dirty old man does not exist. I am what a child molester looks like. I am what a serial killer looks like.
A ghoul, by definition, is a nightmarish fictional creature who takes pleasure in performing unthinkable acts of corpse desecration, a perverse preoccupation which usually culminates in the practice of necrophilia or cannibalism.